everybody. Melissa from CloudMom.com. Welcome to month 12 with your baby. Also month 12 with my baby, Bracey. He's now 52 weeks old, only 42 weeks old in terms of his corrected age since he was born a preemie, but he has made so much progress. The average 12-month-old baby boy weighs 21 pounds, 3 ounces, which is 9.6 kilos. And the average 12-month-old baby girl weighs 19 pounds, 10 ounces, which is 8.9 kilos. Your baby will have an appointment with their pediatrician at 12 months. Your doctor will check your baby's ears, their throat and lungs, take their weight, measure their length and the circumference of their head. Your doctor will assess your baby's back and neck strength. They undoubtedly will ask you if your baby is crawling or cruising or walking or what else they are up to. To get a little more specific, at your baby's 12-month appointment, your doctor might be asking you about the following milestones: pulling up to stand, cruising, which is walking while holding on to furniture, walking without support, using gestures, Bracey has just started to wave, using fingers to self-feed, responding to their name to the word no or to bye-bye, saying a word or two, most babies don't until at least around 14 months, trying to imitate words you say, playing games like peekaboo or patty cake, banging objects together or putting objects into or out of a box. At 12 months, in all likelihood, your baby will be getting a first dose of the following vaccines: MMR, which is the vaccine for measles, mumps, and rubella, Hep A, which is the hepatitis A vaccine. First dose is normally given at between 12 and 23 months, and the second dose is given 6 months later. Varicella, which is the chickenpox vaccine. Your baby, I should say now toddler, also might be getting another dose of the following vaccines: Hep B, which is the vaccine for hepatitis B, Hib, which is a vaccine for hemophilus influenza type B, PCV13, which is the vaccine for pneumococcal, and IPV, which is the vaccine for polio. So you might be asking yourself, when should my baby first go to the dentist? Your baby should first go to the dentist within 6 months of sprouting their first tooth or by the age of one. So if you haven't yet, you should now make an appointment. If you have the feeling that your baby has a cavity or you see white spots, mention this to your dentist. Breastfeeding your baby to sleep or having your baby fall asleep with the bottle are not great habits when it comes to dental hygiene. And a quick note about how to clean your baby's teeth. It used to be said back in the day that all you needed to do when it came to baby teeth was to wipe them after meals and at bedtime with a piece of gauze. Now it's actually recommended, even for young babies, that you use a fluoride-enriched toothpaste with a very, very soft brush or a finger brush, or you can use a piece of gauze after meals and before bedtime to clean your baby's teeth. You should use a minuscule amount of toothpaste. It's said to be the size of a grain of rice. Also, apply the toothpaste to your baby's gums. This is supposed to be great in terms of maintaining your baby's oral hygiene. Your toddler might show signs of becoming a picky eater. How do you deal with this? There's a lot of advice out there and opinions vary greatly, but I'm going to tell you guys what has worked for me, and I've really had my share of picky eaters. My oldest child, who I still consider to be a picky eater, he's now 17, refused to have any vegetables until around month 9. He would only eat sweet fruits like peaches, apples, or pear. It was extremely stressful and very, very difficult. So I've sort of developed my own strategies when it comes to picky eaters, and I wanted to share some of those with you guys. First off, with Headley, I tried to find vegetables that were a little more palatable, such as sweet potato, and I gave him a lot of those. There can be a lot of drama surrounding food. It can cause a lot of stress, and you can easily get into power battles with babies this age because they think it's funny. You give them something and they throw it on the floor or they push it out of their mouth. And the moment they sense that you're getting frustrated by it and they see that reaction, they're gonna do it all the more. So the thing that's worked the best for me, and this is exactly what my pediatrician told me to do, was to just keep introducing healthy, well-rounded meals. A bit of meat, a bit of starch, a bit of vegetable, and for dessert, we always just did fruit and milk during the week. We tried to stay away from sugary sweet desserts, brownies, cookies, and all the rest of that. Here's some other classic tips when it comes to handling a picky eater. Try to opt for having family meals. Involve your child in preparing the meal. Expose your kid to as many types of food as you can from day one. Give a lot of vegetables early on. We're trying to give a lot of vegetables right now to Bracey. Keep introducing foods. Try some savory spices while limiting salt. And try some fun shapes and sizes like triangle-shaped sandwiches and things like that. Kids can tend to find that to be really fun. Intellectual activities for a 12-month-old. The best thing to do for a baby this age is to read as much as possible, talk as much as possible, play music, sing music, and just generally narrate whatever is going on, trying to inject as many words as you can into your baby's day. You really want to let your baby be out there as much as possible exploring the world, and this means a very messy house. Let them go around, let them take the books off the shelves. The other day, Bracey was taking all my hairbrushes out of the bathroom. This is how they learn. They see how objects interact with each other. They feel things and see what they feel like. This is how babies learn about the world. So you don't want to prohibit this at all. And the more you can have your baby out and about in your apartment and otherwise, and not just stuck in a playpen or in a stroller, a swing, a bouncy seat, the better for your baby, because the more physically active they're going to be and the stronger they're going to be and the more they're going to learn. So that's some general advice. Here's a list of some other intellectual activities for your toddler. Hiding and finding objects, playing house, playing making phone calls, but do not give them a phone, playing with water and sand, playing with blocks, sorting shapes, sizes, and colors, playing with basic puzzles, and drawing and finger painting, although I have to confess that I didn't do a lot of this because it was just so messy and I didn't have the energy to deal with the cleanup. At this age, physical activities with your baby will run in tandem with intellectual activities because as your baby goes around exploring the world, they'll be challenging themselves naturally, physically, to get to the next level. Let them do that as much as you can. Keep them on the floor as much as you can. Try to help them stand up as much as you can. Try to help them walk as much as you can. You want to encourage their leg strength, their agility, and their balance. A quick word on cow's milk. From about the age of 6 months, you can mix in cow's milk into your baby's other foods, but you shouldn't be giving your baby cow's milk in lieu of formula or in lieu of breast milk because it doesn't have enough iron, it doesn't have enough vitamin C, and it doesn't have enough of the other essential ingredients that your baby needs. There is also too much protein in cow's milk, and that can cause problems for your baby's kidneys or their digestive system. However, at 1 year of age, you can start to give your baby cow's milk in lieu of formula or breast milk. I'm not going to do this because I'm still nursing Bracey and I want him to be as motivated as possible to stay on the breast. But by all means, if you've weaned your baby or if you are bottle feeding your baby, consider starting to swap out the formula for the cow's milk. When you do decide to give your baby cow's milk, make sure it's whole milk because their brain really needs the fat from the whole milk. You should not be giving 1% milk, low-fat milk, or skim milk to your baby. If you're trying to convert your baby to cow's milk and they don't seem interested, try mixing it with the formula or with the breast milk and then slowly reducing the amount of the breast milk or the formula until you get to solely cow's milk. Okay, what should my schedule look like for my 12-month-old baby? At this stage, most babies are having 3 meals and 2 naps. They have a long morning nap, they have a shorter afternoon nap, and they're sticking to 3 feedings, 3 breastfeedings, and 3 meals. Because Bracey was a preemie and we're still trying to get his weight up because he's at the lower end of the weight charts, I'm sticking with 4 meals. I advise you doing this if your baby was premature, if they're small, or if your baby is not yet sleeping through the night. I would feed more regularly during the day until you get your baby to the point that they're sleeping through the night. I'm linking to the 3-meal-a-day 2-nap schedule from my website on cloudmom.com. I'm just going to throw up again the schedule I'm following with Bracey for those of you that are in line with me because you have a preemie baby or your baby is a bit small or you want them to gain more weight or they're not sleeping through the night. 7 a.m. breast milk, then multigrain cereal mixed with breast milk. Sleep from 9:30 to 11. 11 a.m. breast milk, then a protein, a fish, chicken, or meat, mixed vegetable puree with egg yolk and olive oil, 2 times a week. You really can start at this point substituting for a lot of finger foods. I've been giving Bracey the finger foods while I'm feeding him the puree, so he has both of those elements during his meal. 3 p.m. breast milk, then a mixed fresh fruit puree. You can substitute for finger foods. Sleep from 6 to 7 p.m. and 7 p.m. breast milk, and then multigrain cereal mixed with breast milk. Bottle feeding. At 12 months, your baby should start transitioning away from the bottle, and in fact, the AAP recommends that by 18 months, your baby is no longer taking a bottle. This can be a huge struggle for many parents. I actually have a very strange tip that I developed through having had so much nipple confusion with Bracey, who I really battled with during months and months and months to make sure that he was breastfeeding and not taking the bottles. If you're really desperate and you can't get your baby off the bottle, you can spoon feed them the formula. It takes a little longer, but this is a way to just say completely bye-bye to the bottle cold turkey and make sure at the same time that your baby is getting the formula or the milk they need. With that said, here are some other tips for transitioning away from the bottle. Start early as 6 months. Start with a silicone spout. Offer diluted juice at first. Begin offering a sippy cup. And as I just said, go cold turkey. Throw the bottles away and spoon feed or offer a sippy cup. This can be really stressful and you might end up with a lot of crying fits, but in the end, your baby will likely cave. If not, talk to your doctor. Just as I described in the breastfeeding section, your baby at this point might be ready for 3 meals and 2 naps. I link to that schedule from cloudmom.com. You'll likely see a longer morning nap and a shorter afternoon nap. If again, however, your baby was a preemie or is small or is not sleeping through the night, you still can stick to a 4-meal-a-day, 3-nap schedule. Here it is again, I throw it up every month for convenience. 7 a.m. a bottle, then multigrain cereal mixed with formula. Sleep from 9:30 to 11 a.m. 11 a.m. a bottle and then a protein, a fish, chicken, or meat mixed vegetable puree with an egg yolk and olive oil 2 times a week. 3 p.m. a bottle, then a mixed fresh fruit puree, or you can substitute this for finger foods. Sleep from 6 to 7. And 7 p.m., a bottle, then a multigrain cereal mixed with breast milk. Here is the Bracey update. Bracey celebrated his first birthday. He was thrilled to receive a lot of new fun and hopefully educational toys and games. Bracey is crawling around really fast and he's getting into all sorts of trouble all over the house and messing up every time I try to make things nice and neat. I have to be on constant watch, and actually one of my upcoming projects is to try to find a big enough play yard where he can play in the living room because I just found him going through the garbage. Bracey has started waving. Bracey also took a plane flight to Amsterdam and he really enjoyed seeing the city. I'm sending so much love to all of you guys. I cannot believe this year is over. I'm so excited for you to be celebrating your baby's first birthday. I'm gonna be continuing this series, so check back in with me next month, you guys, for month 13.